Welcome to Dell Technologies RecoverPoint for Virtual Machines How-To Series. RecoverPoint for Virtual Machines. How to Replicate Virtual Disk UUID. Reference Dell Knowledge Article Number 19758. This video was created to illustrate how to replicate virtual machines UUID when using RecoverPoint for Virtual Machines. When to do this. If you are using a guest operating system or application that requires virtual machines to have the same UUID. Before you begin, make sure you have access to RecoverPoint admin or box management account password for main menu access, RecoverPoint Flex or HTML5 plugin interface which will require access to vCenter administrator credentials, VMware KB Article 52815. Open a web browser and log into vSphere HTML5 interface with administrator account. Select the source VM that you need to enable UUID replication for, right-click the VM and power it off. Open a PuTTY session to one of the VRPs with admin or box management account to gain access to the main menu. Note that if you are using RecoverPoint version 5.3 or later, you can skip this step and go directly to step 2 of the KBA. Follow the steps shown on the screen to go to Appliance Configuration Parameters. Enter the tweak value shown on the screen. Follow the options on the screen to reboot the VRPA. Once reboot is completed, make sure to follow the same steps on all other RPAs in the system. Go back to the HTML5 interface and right-click the VM, click on Edit Settings. Click on VM Options, then a select Advanced. Click on Edit Configuration, in Configuration Parameters. Click Add Configuration Parameters and insert the values shown on the screen. Click OK to save the changes. Wait for the reconfiguration task to complete, then right-click the VM to power it on. Once VM is powered on, right-click and select the RecoverPoint tab to protect. Open a web browser and log into vSphere HTML5 interface with administrator account. Go to the RecoverPoint for Virtual Machines tab. Click on Protection, then Consistency Groups tab. Select the consistency group containing the VM you need to enable disk UUID replication for and disable it. Click on Hosts and Clusters. Right-click the protected VM and power it off. Open a PuTTY session to one of the VRPs with admin or box management account to gain access to the main menu. Note that if you are using RecoverPoint version 5.3 or later, you can skip this step and go directly to step 2 of the KBA. Follow the steps shown on the screen to go to Appliance Configuration Parameters. Enter the tweak value shown on the screen. Follow the options on the screen to reboot the VRPA. Once reboot is completed, make sure to follow the same steps on all other RPAs in the system. Go back to the HTML5 interface and right-click the VM, click on Edit Settings. Click on VM Options, then a select Advanced. Click on Edit Configuration and Configuration Parameters, click Add Configuration Parameters and insert the values shown on the screen. Click OK to save the changes. Wait for the reconfiguration task to complete, then right-click the VM to power it on. Go back to the RecoverPoint plugin tab. Click Protection tab, then go to Consistency Groups. Reselect the consistency group to enable it back. Once CG is active, use Test a Copy tab to enable image access and validate that both source and production VM has the same UUID. Important notes. In case the following tweak was set on versions prior to 5.3, it must be reverted back before upgrading, as it will cause upgrade to 5.3 versions to fail. Since this tweak is added by default to version 5.3 and later, updating it on 5.3 may cause RPA to crash. Reference: VMware KB Article 52815. Thank you for watching.